Understand me, Marshall. Marshall loves and understands Dr. Pepper, the most misunderstood soft drink in America. So how come you don't understand me, Marshall? How come?
WBBM-TV, Channel 2, Chicago. In order that we may present the Chicago Emmy show, WBBM-TV will not carry the Carol Burnett Show tonight. The Carol Burnett Show returns next week at its usual time on Channel 2.
Tonight, live from the Drury Lane Theater, the Chicago chapter of the National Academy of Television and Arts and Sciences presents the 12th Annual Chicago Emmy Awards. Now, the president of the Chicago chapter of the Television Academy, Edward L. Morris.
Thank you very much. It's a great pleasure to welcome the Chicago public here tonight to this most festive of all nights in Chicago television, the awarding of the annual Emmys for the Chicago chapter of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences. It's a great honor and privilege for me to stand here before you tonight as the retiring president of this chapter of the Academy and to say with great pride what a pleasure it has been to serve in this capacity. It's a great honor. It's a great honor to be a part of such a magnificent industry in a city like Chicago. And though I go from here to New York, which they call the first city, Chicago will always be the first city so far as I'm concerned. And there is absolutely no question about our firstness insofar as creativity, because creativity has been the watchword, and it's magnificent to see the kind of competition that takes place in our community. And when it comes down to Emmy night and we separate the winners from the losers, there really are no losers, because after all, we're all winners as we sit here in this room tonight as a part of an industry which can create as much as we've created in our own great city. So it is a great honor and a privilege. It's been a pleasure to serve you, but I know we're all here to find out how we separate the men from the boys. It's certainly easy to tell which ones are the girls tonight. And at that point, it seems to me that we ought to turn this microphone and this podium over to a real pro. And it's my great pleasure to salute CBS's Merv Griffin, who will take over as Master of Ceremonies. Mr. Griffin, thank you.
Bow here without getting in trouble. It's a constant thing you have to do. Well, I'm very pleased to be the host of the 12th annual Evergreen Park Emmy Awards. Well, it's true. Chicago's two blocks that way, they told me. Right? This is, of course, the Drury Lane Theater, and it's beautiful, and it's in the round, and it's quite a challenge because you have to be as charming in the back as you are in the front. Thank you. You probably think I'm going to say this because I'm just here tonight, but I love Chicago. Beginnings of my career happened a great deal in here in Chicago. I was with Dorothy Hilde out at the Edgewater Beach Hotel for many summers, opening the Beach Walk and playing the Aragon Ballroom. And I really love Chicago. My most exciting nights in my life are here in Chicago. I came in yesterday. You want to tell you what I did that was exciting? Came in yesterday so I'd have a night off here first, and I got an invitation to that mansion. And I told my wife I had to work hard here in Chicago. So some of the gang, we went over there, and that is very exciting. We stood around and watched Hefner light his pipe. And boy, that's exciting. Then somebody said, go to the pump room. We went over there, or as it's known as Cup's Kitchen, and watched the guys flip the crepe Suzettes. That was terrific. Then I went home and listened to Tornado Warnings. What a town. That's great. Well, as you know, the Emmy Awards are for excellence, entertainment, intelligence, and any program not criticized by Spiro Agnew. These awards are more important. Is she here? He was coming to Chicago, but then when he found out that there was a 3-year wait on tickets to Bozo the Clown, he canceled out. Things have changed here. Do you know that I can remember when Chicago 7 was a television station? It's gotten wild here. Things I see, like, what other city in America would Playboy After Dark be listed as a public service program? It gets wilder all the time. I hear a local news coverage, since it's been extended, from now on they're going to ask the demonstrators to join AFTRA. Because they're getting a lot of time. I think we better get to the business at hand here, honoring those who have achieved excellence in the medium of television. To make the first presentation, I have the pleasure of introducing Channel 11's lovely Carol Bryant and Channel 2's big news anchorman, Wayne Farris.
Carol, let's not keep them in suspense any longer. Find out what's in that envelope.
Okay, I can hardly wait myself. For devising excellent, entertaining choreography that truly advanced the theme of WMAQ-TV's The New Performers, Chicagoland 69, an Emmy goes to choreographer Alan Baker.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, and particularly thank you to all those wonderful young kids who work so hard. I suppose last summer they spent all their time soaking in hot baths every night after I got to the living. Thank you.
And now I'll see what's in this one. For effectively translating print journalism into an entertaining television display of important issues of the day in a fast-moving hour with both humor and pathos, an Emmy goes to WMAQ-TV's Royko at Best.
I'd just like to say thank you to a wonderful company of players, a great crew, to Harry Trigg, whose guiding hand behind the scenes helped us a lot, to Bill Heitz for his sensitive direction, and of course to a great Chicago writer, Mike Royko. Thank you.
We'll be back with Merv Griffin, Eloise Laws, and the Arbors after this message.
Bottle salad dressings? Move over. Hellman's is here. Make your own fresh pour-on salad dressings with real mayonnaise.
Scoop it up, thin it down, slice it up, stir it around and wow!
French, Russian, Italian, you name it. Better than bottle because you make it yourself. Easy recipes right on the jar. Hellman's.
What could be fresher?
It's a real thing. Coke is.
That's the way it should be.
Coca-Cola.
What the world wants to see.
Oh, yeah.
It's a real thing.
Coca-Cola. That's the way it is.
With a bottle of Coke.
And the way it will stay.
For the taste of your life.
What the world wants today.
Oh, yeah.
It's a real thing.
Coca-Cola.
It's Coke. that funny crown? Well, you just spread some imperial margarine on your bread. It tastes so good, it makes you feel like a queen, and you get a crown. Try some. Mmm, it tastes good, but I didn't get a crown. You're fooling me. Try it again. See? It takes a little longer for boys.
Regular, soft spread, and diet imperial.
And now to make the next presentation, we have Channel 26's lovely weather girl, Janet Langhart, and the star of Life with Father that's playing right here at the Drury Lane, Mr. Forrest Tucker.
Tell you, at my age, it's pretty safe when you kiss boys, but get in a little trouble kissing girls, I'll tell you. Merv, nice to see you here with us in Chicago. Hey, what do you got to say now? What are you going to do?
Mr. Tucker?
No, the printing is on this side, honey. Yeah.
For his conception and execution of the space exploration segment of the WMAQ TV program, 1969, it was the best of times, it was the worst of times, a reflection. And Emmy goes to John Martin.
Hey.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate this, and I think I've said sufficient. Thank you very much.
By golly, I don't think anybody would accuse him of being loquacious, would they? Well, here. For his consummate skill in giving factual and objective reporting on WBBM TV, coupled with his legal background to give viewers an understanding of the legal technicalities surrounding the Conspiracy 8 trial in Chicago. And then he goes to Bill Curtis.
You know, we lost one along the way. It dropped down to Chicago 7, but you had to have a scorecard to tell what was going on.
For God's sake, say something good, you know.
I really didn't think I'd have to have anything to remember the Chicago 7 trial, but this is a very good remembrance. I think that half of this belongs to Marcia Danitz and Silvio Gaetone, who provided the artist's work. And my thanks to the Channel 2 newsroom for putting up with the late deadlines and to Phil Murray for directing and finding his way through that artwork. And thank you very much.
I guess you and I have done our little stint here. We turn it back to old Merv.
Let's do that.
You want to come over and have a little toddy for the body with me? Huh?
Yes.
He's higher than the Hancock Building. Don't, he's liable to come back. How fast they forget. Not even a kiss goodbye, did you notice? To present the next awards, I would like to introduce Lee Phillips, hostess of Channel 2's Lee Phillips Show, and the star of Shot in the Dark at the Ivanhoe Theater. From Hogan's Heroes, you'll villain joy, Werner Klemper.
Thank you.
some of those rules on Hogan and his heroes.
Well, darling, I must tell you, looking at you, I'll never relax. I certainly will. I would like you to have to just be in the camp forever.
Oh, no. Thank you. I'm happy right here.
Okay.
I'll open up this envelope now.
All right.
For a series of original half-hour dramas, which created a number of firsts for Chicago television, utilizing the creative talents of Chicago black actors, writers, and creative craftsmen, in programs that were both personal and meaningful, an Emmy goes to WTTW's Bird of an Iron Feather.
Some weeks ago, I wasn't going to accept this. I was going to give it to the station for John Taylor and Ed Morris, who showed a great deal of courage. But my wife said to me, you have no right to deprive your children to say, my father did this. Yeah. So I accept that. For producing a number of entertaining tunes, which at the same time were meaningful in terms of saying something, Emmys go to the composer and lyricist team for the new performers, Chicagoland 69 on WMAQ-TV, Lloyd Nolan and Dan Schaffman.
There are a few people that have to be thanked for just accepting the concept of the new performers, and they begin with Mr. Robert Lemon at NBC, Mr. Bud Prather, Harry Trigg, and last but not least, a gentleman who moved with us through the entire production of the new performers, the general director, Dr. William Peterman. And for myself, thanks to the Academy, thank you very much.
I second the motion. Thank you.
I'd like you now to meet a young, new singing group. They're four young men, two sets of brothers, and you'll recognize a pair of twins in there, too, easily. Exciting group who are doing wonderful things all over the country, and they got their start right here in Chicago. Here are the Arbors.
I was alone, I took a ride, I didn't know what I would find there. Another road where maybe I could see another kind of life there.
Ooh, did I suddenly see you?
Ooh,
did I tell you I need you?
Every single day of my life. You didn't run, you didn't lie, you know I wanted just to hold you. And had you gone, you knew the time we'd meet again, for I'd have told you. I feel good in a special way. I'm in love and it's a sunny day. Good day, sunshine. Good day, sunshine. Good day, sunshine. To take a walk, the sun is shining down. Burns my feet as it touch the ground. Good day, sunshine. Good day, sunshine. Good day, sunshine. Good day, sunshine.
Then I suddenly see you. Did I tell you I need you?
Every single day of my life.
spiral
like a wheel within a wheel,
never ending or beginning,
on an ever spinning reel,
like a snowball down a mountain or a carnival balloon,
like a carousel that's turning, running
rings around the moon,
like a clock whose hands are sweeping
past the minutes
of its face.
The world is like an apple
silently in space,
like the circles that you find
in the windmills of your
mind, like a tunnel that you follow to a tunnel of its own, down a hollow to a cavern where the sun has never shone, like a door that keeps revolving in a half-forgotten dream,
or the ripples from
a pebble someone tosses in a stream, like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its face. The world is like an apple whirling silently in space, like the circles that you find in the windmills of your mind,
in the windmills of your mind.
Keys that jingle in your pocket,
words that jangle in your head.
Why did summer go so quickly?
Was it something that you said?
Lovers walk along
ashore and leave their footprints in the sand. Is the sound of distant drumming just the fingers of your
pictures
head?
Hanging in a hallway,
and the fragment of a song,
half-remembered names and faces.
But to whom do they belong?
When you knew that it was over, you were suddenly that the autumn leaves were turning to the color of her hair,
like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel, never ending or beginning, on an ever-spinning wheel,
as the images unwind,
like the circles that you find in the windmills of your mind,
in the windmills of your mind.
Here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey.
Are you going to Scarborough Fair? Parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme. Remember me to one who lives there. She once was a true love of mine. Tell her to find me an acre of land on a hillside covered with vine, between the salt water and the sea strand. Then she'll be a true love of mine. Then she'll be a true love of mine. Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
I've come to talk with you again.
I've come to talk with you again.
Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone. Narrow streets of cobblestone. Neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light that split the night. Sound of silence. We'd like to know a little bit about you for a fight.
All right.
We'd like to help you learn to help yourself. Look around you, all you see are sympathetic eyes. Stroll around the grounds until you feel at home. And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mrs. Robinson. Heaven holds a place for those who pray. Hey, hey, hey.
The 12th Annual Chicago Emmy Award presentation will continue after these messages.
You can really get to know the child you've been raising when you're somewhere that's not like home. Florida. Eastern Airlines can show him and you a whole new world of experience in Florida. Come, we'll be your wings to a summer to remember. Call your travel agent or Eastern, the wings of man.
Meet Mrs. Bonnie Harrison of Camp Hill, Pennsylvania. She's got a story to tell that only a mother can appreciate.
Well, a while back, my neighbor had her first baby, and she wanted to borrow some of Jay's baby clothes, but nearly all of them were stained with formula and baby food that had been there nearly 3 years. Well, I had a 15-cent off coupon for Tide XK, and I figured it was worth a try. When I took the clothes out, I was shocked. Tide XK got them looking practically new again, and I wasn't the least bit ashamed to lend them to a new baby. So now I'm sold on Tide XK. It's the first time I've ever really been proud of my wash.
Incredible Tide XK with stain-removing XK enzymes. It's so powerful, it soaks out stains while it washes out dirt. And if you don't believe it, write Mrs. Bonnie Harrison, Post Office Box 900, Camp Hill, Pennsylvania.
I'd like now to introduce the hostess of Channel 7's prize movie, I Own, and NBC's Floyd Calber. Not the news department.
Oh, Floyd, you disappointed me. You told me up there you were going to kiss Merv.
That was my suggestion.
Oh!
That he kiss you.
Oh, I know, but you seemed like
you were... Would you believe that I know every word of Mrs. Robinson?
Do you really? Would you believe that I'm really Mrs. Robinson?
Ask my wife. And they didn't ask me to join them.
They didn't.
But I joined them back there.
Oh, you did?
Present.
Okay. All right. For a performance which demonstrated his versatility, from flawless comic timing in one sketch to pathos or whimsy in another, on WMAQ-TV's Roy Coe at Best, an Emmy goes to actor Ronnie Graham.
Roy Graham. Hello, Roy.
No, I'm not Ronnie Graham. Ronnie Graham is preparing a new show in New York and cannot be here. But I know he is very happy with the nomination, will be thrilled with this. And so to the Academy, and from Ronnie, and from those of us who admire him so much, thank you.
Never.
Is that Forrest Tucker up there? For a documentary which carefully examined the components of hunger and malnutrition in Chicago, the social classes affected, and the efforts of the city and private agencies to meet the problem, an Emmy goes to WTTW's To Feed the Hungry.
Accepting the award is producer John Summers.
Thank you very much. I would like to quickly acknowledge those people to whom this Emmy goes. To our fine editor, Richard Sato, to our enterprising cameraman, Cal Langenberg, and to Bill Harris, who initiated the project by his interest, and particularly to Mrs. Linda Rocky, whose series of articles in the Chicago Sun-Times were the basis for this program. On their behalf and my own, I wish to thank the Academy very much.
I think Tucker is running a private party in the back there. We're very fortunate with us to have with us tonight a gentleman whose career has included working with ABC, NBC, CBS, Warner Brothers. Obviously had a trouble holding down a job. But he has a very distinguished title right now. He is the president of the National Academy of Television, Arts, and Sciences. My good friend, Mr. Robert Lewine.
I wish I could tell you that I'm made speechless by your welcome, but unfortunately I'm not. The program says that I bring you greetings from the National Academy, and so I do. And on behalf of the more than 6,000 members in 10 chapter cities in the United States, I'd like to tell you first how we feel about our Emmy Awards. And about our members. There are no people more qualified than those who work in television to set standards of excellence for themselves and their medium, and none for whom it is more important to establish goals of achievement. And that's what our awards are all about: excellent, achievement, and goals. Let those who win these awards know then that the fullest possible measure of our creativity, energy, time, and resources have been devoted to their selection. And let their acceptance of these awards carry with it the responsibility to raise the sights even higher so that television's full potential to inform, to entertain, to educate, and to inspire may be realized. And now I'd like to say a few words about Chicago, specifically our Chicago chapter. If the National Academy were to give Emmys to its chapters, I think that the Chicago chapter would have won more than any of our nine other chapters. Ever since Irv Kupcinet founded it 12 years ago, it has been a leader within the National Academy family. And we know it holds that position in this community, thanks to its leadership, the initiative, the dedication, the vitality. In the 8 years that we've given a station award for those stations contributing to their communities with public service programming, a Chicago station has won either a regional Emmy or a national Emmy for 7 of those years. We of the National are very proud of our Chicago chapter, and I think they have every reason to be proud of themselves. And now, I've been asked to present the Governor's Award. For exceptional innovation in designing and developing as a group the joint antenna system on top of the Hancock Building, which has greatly improved television signals and will accommodate future television stations to the full extent of the 10 that are signed to Chicago. The Board of Governors has voted an award to the Chicago Broadcasters Antenna Committee, accepting was not put on my card. Who is the gentleman accepting? Don't go away. I'm prepared for all emergencies. Accepting William P. Cusack.
As a former chairman of the Chicago Broadcast Antenna Committee, it is my pleasure to accept this award. And I may say that the Chicago Broadcast Antenna Committee, for your information, consists of the chief engineers and their able assistants of the stations now on top of the John Hancock building. Therefore, it is our pleasure to accept this award with humble gratitude and considerable pride for your recognition and its accomplishment. Thank you.
Thank you too, Bob. A rare moment for all of you, I'm sure. A regular member of our family is here. And incidentally, I should have said before this that Arthur Treacher did want to be here with us tonight. We have been taking him out of town on weekends, though. lately. I brought him here to Chicago a year ago. We did a show, and he still considers himself a swinger, romantically. And he's going to hit 76 this July. And we checked into this hotel. It's his agent who doesn't believe it either. We checked in this hotel, and he hung a sign on his door that said, "Please disturb," which embarrassed all of us in the group. He's a terrific man and a dear friend. Another regular member of my family is this extraordinary young girl you're going to hear sing right now. She's a great beauty with a great voice, and she's Eloise Laws. Eloise?
The willow weeps and having wept can weep no more, but still it cries for me, cries in sympathy, knows that you are gone. Don't leave me, baby. There was a time when you were mine, not so long ago I used to say you'd never go away, never leave me lonely. Don't leave me, baby. Happy times, the groovy times, don't tell me they are gone. I just can't carry on. I know that you're not here, you're not near anymore. Oh, 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 don't leave me, baby. Things are gonna work out fine. Don't leave me, baby. Think I'm going out of my mind. Don't leave me, baby. Don't leave me behind.
feeling small. When tears are in your eyes, I will dry them all. Oh, I'm on your side. Oh, when times get rough and friends just can't be found, like a bridge over troubled water, I would lay me down like a bridge over troubled water. I would lay me
Chromacolor, Zenith's revolutionary system of color TV. It starts with Zenith's Titan handcrafted chassis and exclusive chromatic brain. But the big difference is inside our patented Chromacolor picture tube. Zenith fully illuminates every color dot to bring you a color picture that outcolors, outbrightens, outcontrasts, and outdetails every giant screen color picture before Chromacolor. Compare Chromacolor. Only Zenith has it.
Taste me, taste me. Come on and taste me.
Alice, your purse is singing.
Silly, purses don't sing. It's my cigarettes. Doral.
Take a puff and let me do my stuff.
Doral shows its tar nicotine numbers and has a unique filter system that delivers so much flavor, it says, taste me.
Taste marvelous.
When I carry my green bag, I smoke Doral menthol with a false green tip.
Huge.
Taste me.
I'm going to take a shower now without soap, and I bet I'll be cleaner than you.
I use something that makes me feel cleaner than soap. Zest. Deodorant Zest. It's not a soap, it's different.
Look, Zest makes twice the lather. Deodorant lather. It's packed with active deodorant.
And watch this.
Soap leaves a soap film that sticks to your skin. Not Zest. That's why Zest leaves you feeling cleaner than soap.
The pleasure of introducing the co-host of Channel 5's Sunday in Chicago program, Miss Betty Autumn, and Channel 9's newsman, Jack Taylor.
Okay, I'm first.
All right. I just wanted to say that it's a great honor and a pleasure and a privilege to be here. I am a presenter, and I'm proud to be a presenter. It would be a much greater honor, of course, to receive an Emmy, but I just keep reminding myself what my preaching grandpa used to say. It is more blessed to give than to receive.
Speaking of preaching, it reminds me of when I was in Mississippi, I used to hear them talk about the land of milk and honey. Well, I'm here. This is just like real television.
Shall we present?
Of course. I never really liked to read Cole, but for its unique concept in using 28 high school students chosen in community-wide auditions and blending their talents into a well-produced entertaining program of original music, an Emmy goes to WMAQ-TV's The New Performers, Chicagoland, 1969.
Accepting the award is producer Dan Shuffman.
I'd like to share with you how I feel about what I do. I once did a program out at Argonne, and I talked to a scientist who was working in chemistry, and he was so enthusiastic about what he was doing, and I said, "You really like to be out here?" And he said, "I'll tell you the truth. They pay me. I'd pay them. And I thank you very much." That's how I feel about this business.
For a program which presented a serious problem, willful pollution of our environment, in a dramatically effective manner, an Emmy goes to WMAQ-TV's Alone in the Midst of the Land.
Accepting the award is producer Scott Craig.
It's with somewhat mixed emotions that I accept an Emmy for a program that was about the destruction of our environment. But nonetheless, I am grateful. And all of us who worked on that film, Jim Strickland, cameraman, Glenn McGowan, editor, all of us hope that in some way that film will have something to do with the cleaning up of the mess that's been created. Thank you.
Betty Odom and Jack Taylor. To make the next presentations, Channel 9's hostess of the Romper Room, Elizabeth Trench, and one half of the Flynn Daily News team, Fahey Flynn.
Well, do you think all the little romper rumors are
I hope
asleep?
They're in bed by now. I just want to make one comment, Fahey.
What?
I noticed that you're not the only one tonight with a bow tie on, so do you feel out of place?
Oh, so true. Why don't you open up and
do the honors?
Do the honors.
For displaying excellence in creating well-designed stage pictures, great skill in blocking, artistry in the choice of shots and cutting, an Emmy goes to the director of WMAQ's TV's Royko at Best, Bill Height.
Oh.
I think Scott Craig has thanked most of the people who need to be thanked. I would just add a couple of more people to that. They're a very splendidly professional group of stagehands and engineers. Thank you.
I wasn't trying to read over your shoulder. Just trying to see whether I could read mine without my glasses. For outstanding performance on the most successful children's show in the history of Chicago television, An Enemy goes to WGN-TV's Bozo the Clown.
Accepting the award for Bob Bell is co-performer Ray Rayner.
Bozo, you all know, is Bob Bell.
I look like Bozo.
I am Ray Rayner, and I have the privilege of accepting this for Bob Bell. Fine, capital F-I-N-E, excellent talent, Mr. Bob Bell. We have a kind of a needling common in the mornings. Excuse me, Liz. We are tongue-in-cheek, old Oliver and Cookie and Mr. Ned, we may say, where would you be, Bozo, without us? But Bozo Circus, I think, would have run about 3 months without the great Bozo and Bob Bell, and it'll be starting its 10th year in September. Bob Bell, thanks you very much.
Since Avis doesn't expect it will happen, we make this pledge. If you rent a Plymouth from us that has over 19,000 miles on the odometer, you can keep it. When a woman breaks a nail, it's not a very serious thing. Or is it? Build up your nails with Knox, the gelatin drink in three great flavors, orange, grape, cranberry. Just stir and drink. From Knox, the people who know nails from the inside out.
Here comes Mr. Wonderful.
Oh, my hair!
Did you ever feel like putting a bag over your head to hide your dirty hair? That's how I used to feel, until I discovered Liquid Prel Shampoo. Gets rid of the dirt, gets my hair the cleanest possible clean. And I look better in clean hair than this any day. Right?
Right.
Liquid Prel, extra rich in ingredients that clean hair best.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Merv Griffin.
I'd like to close the proceedings by singing for you, Mort. Thank you. Don't look over there. Everybody's talking at me, but I don't hear a word they're saying. Carson, Cabot, Cubson, only the echoes of my mind. People stop and staring. I can't see the faces, only the shadows of their eyes. I'm going where the sun keeps shining through the pouring rain. Going where the weather suits my clothes. Banking off of the northeast wind, sailing on a summer breeze, skipping over the ocean like a stone. Shining through the pouring rain,
going where the weather suits my clothes. I'm banking off of the northeast wind. I'm sailing on a summer breeze. Skipping over the ocean like a stone. Everybody's talking at me.
Well, I've had a marvelous evening here, and I thank you all. I particularly thank my orchestra leader, who was a National Emmy winner last year for conducting Barbra Streisand in Central Park, where she was mugged on television. No, sheep's head special. And I congratulate all of the winners. You've been an extraordinary audience, and I thank you for inviting me to Chicago for this affair. Good night, and God bless you. Thank you.
Transportation furnished by United Airlines.
Little Kodak Instamatic 44 camera took those gorgeous pictures. I thought this was a toy. No, this is the real thing.
A Kodak Instamatic camera for less than $10. A great little camera and a great little gift.
You're looking at $100 worth of fun. It's a United Friendly Skies coupon book, and there are four more like it. Good for discounts in five great cities. New York, Washington, D.C., Los Angeles, San Francisco, and Honolulu. On theater tickets, dinners, shopping, you name it. Take a United vacation to any of these cities and it's yours free.
Fly the friendly skies of United.
WBBM-TV, Channel 2, Chicago.
Good evening. I hope you'll pardon my being overdressed a bit for this particular occasion, but I've just returned from the Emmys, and there was not time to change clothes and also find out what was going on in the world and around Chicago. There are strong indications tonight that the state aid to private and parochial schools is dead in this session of the Illinois legislature. The Senate voted this afternoon not to release a House-approved bill from committee. State Senator Harris Faywell, a leading opponent of the measure, said leaders of both parties are exerting pressure to pass an aid bill.
Just the basic fact that you have the governor of your party, for instance, twisting arms, as he has said, and here is a man who can either sign or not sign the appropriation bills, for instance, for public improvements in a senator's district. Here is a man who has control of patronage, which is important to a number of senators. Here is a man who is the governor and has the tremendous weight and the prestige of that office. And when you have